Kyle. So I'm sure you already heard the big news. Two different transactions have just happened recently today. Unique Ngogwe has been traded, and Dez Bryant has signed with the team. The Ravens are the beneficiary of both those transactions. So it's kind of, you know, pretty big news, especially if you're a Ravens fan and especially if you're a fan of teams in the AFC North. So let's just get right into it. The Ravens will send a 2021 third round pick and a 2022 conditional fifth round pick to the Vikings for Ngogwe, according to sources that told ESPN's Adam Schefter. So, I mean, obviously that's pretty accurate. So the Ravens are currently third in sacks with 22 sacks this season. So it's just, he's only going to add to that pass rush. Also, him and Calais Campbell did play together in Jacksonville, so that should help him ease into that locker room. You know, he'll introduce him to those guys, so it'll help gel that defense even quicker for him. And then obviously it's a matter of him, you know, learning the scheme, getting into it. But him and Judon, now those two guys can just designate to one side. They don't need to move around, and they will be a nightmare for offenses moving forward. So, and you don't have to, you have to consider, and Ngogwe already has 5 sacks this season. He's one of the top sack leaders, tied with a lot of great pass rushers. So you have to consider that too. He's just going to add to that. So the big news, let's get into it. Dez Bryant. Okay, so a lot of people have been waiting for this day. A lot of people questioning, you know, especially Cowboys fans last year, why not sign Dez, blah, blah, blah. So obviously, you know, 2018, signs with the Saints. 2 days later, he ruptures Achilles. So very unfortunate. He's a great player. So it's kind of interesting to see, will this kind of be a revival of his career, or will this just be he's there for a couple weeks and they never really do anything with him? It's kind of interesting to see. So obviously, I can give some stats on probably why they brought him in, and a concern for Lamar Jackson's game, not necessarily maybe being his fault, or maybe it is. You interpret it how you want. I'm not going to give my opinion on that. So let's just get into some of the stats, and we'll be on our way. We'll do this quick. So 63% completion percentage in the last 3 games, 7-yard average, 90.1 QB rating. That's all in the last 3 games, plus 190 yards average in those games. So passing wise, obviously he hasn't been doing anything that stands out. I will say that. And they're against not very good opponents. So, you know, interpret that how you will. There's a lot of reasons you could say maybe he doesn't need to be that great, or maybe it's his receivers that have not really helped him out. You know, you interpret that as you will. But this is why I suspect Dez was brought in. Obviously, he's a deep threat. And that's kind of where Lamar has really struggled this year. And the Ravens as a whole have struggled this year. So passes of 10-plus yards. We'll start with that. 114 passer rating, which isn't terrible. He has 5 touchdowns, 425 yards, and he's only thrown 1 pick. So obviously, it could be better. He could have more yardage, maybe a couple more touchdowns, but let's not be too picky. It's early in the season. It's been a weird year, so we'll see what happens with that. But 20-plus yards is where it gets kind of concerning. Again, you can either blame him, or maybe you can blame his receivers, and there is a stat that you could definitely lead towards that. So with 20-plus yards of 20-plus yards, or passes of 20-plus yards, sorry, he's ranked 7th in deep ball percentage, which obviously isn't too bad, but he also, with 14.2%, obviously I should throw that in there, and he's bottom 10 in deep ball touchdowns, and I think he has 2, I didn't get that stat written down, but, and this is another thing that's a little bit concerning, he's 24th in passing yards with 181, so, I mean, that's a pretty big difference, and he only has 1 touchdown and 6 completions in 20-plus yard throws. So, I mean, he's behind people like Phillip Rivers, Baker Mayfield, Teddy Bridgewater. So when you're behind company like that, it's a little bit of a concern. But you also have to consider the fact that he's one of few QBs with 2 or more drop passes in that category too. So his wide receivers may not be helping him in that case too. So that's something else you have to consider. So, you know, take those stats as you will. It's pretty big news. If you're a Ravens fan, you're probably pretty pumped up. I don't blame you. So, if you haven't already, please like and subscribe right down below. And also, if you haven't signed up for Thrive Fantasy, please do use code ASPIRE. We'd love it. And thank you for tuning in. Have a great day.